this video, I'll show you how to detect collisions on a per-pixel basis. Collision response is unique to each game, so I'll save that for my next video, where I'll demonstrate player movement and collisions in my 2D platformer. When checking for collision between two sprites, the color information doesn't matter, so we can create a collision mask representing each sprite, which stores a 0 for empty pixels and a 1 for solid. This also gives us flexibility to make parts of a sprite non-colliding by editing the mask. Here's a simple function that loops through a sprite's pixels and creates a mask based on it. Throughout this video, the animations will show sprites, but the collision code will use masks made from them. One of our sprites, the Croak & Carrow logo, is stationary in the middle of the screen. The other sprite, a potato, moves around. We need to find the area where the masks overlap, if any, then loop through the corresponding pixels in each mask and check whether they have any pixels in the same spot. This check collision function takes two masks, A and B, and their positions, then returns true when the masks collide and false otherwise. We get the left and right pixel columns and bottom and top rows of each mask. We can check if A's left is right of B's right, A's bottom is above B's top, and so on, and if any of these conditions are true, there's no overlap and we can early out. If there is an overlap, we find that box by taking the rightmost of A's and B's lefts, the leftmost of their rights, and so on. The number of pixel columns is equal to the right minus left plus 1, and similar for rows. We know how many rows and columns of the masks will be checked, but we need to translate the overlap position to corresponding starting points within each of the mask's pixels. We do that by subtracting A's left position from the overlap's left, and A's bottom position from the overlap's bottom. The same for B. Now we just need to iterate through the number of rows and columns, comparing the pixel at A left plus X, A bottom plus Y, and B left plus X, B bottom plus Y. If they're both solid, we have a collision, so we return true. If we make it through every overlapping pixel without finding two solids in the same place, we reach the end of the function and return false. This is the most basic pixel collision detection, but from here you can make loads of custom collision functions. For the sake of demonstration, here's a function which writes a red pixel to the frame buffer for every colliding pixel. That about does it for pixel collision detection. In my next video, I'll show you how I've implemented collision response in my 2D platformer. The code is available for download at the text version of this tutorial, linked below. Cheers!